Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. And I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy. I want to see you, and I want to see you. And open the eyes of my heart, Lord, and open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you, and I want to see you. To see you high. Shining in the light of your glory, pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory, pour out your power and love as we sing holy.
You're listening to Soul Cafe Radio, food for the mind and soul.
that God has made it our duty to pray. The riches of the universe belong to Him. He has all temporal and spiritual treasures at His command and can supply everyone to His abundant fulfillment. We receive our breath from Him. Every temporal blessing that we enjoy is His gift. We are dependent upon Him, not only for temporal blessings, but for grace and strength to keep us from falling under the power of temptation. We daily need the bread of life to give us spiritual strength and vigor. Just as much as we need truth to sustain our physical strength and give us firm muscles. We are compassed with weakness and infirmity, doubt and temptation, but we can come to Jesus in our need, and he will not turn us away empty. We must accustom ourselves to seek divine guidance in His word. We must learn to trust in Him from whom our help comes. We must have a deep, earnest sense of our need. We must feel our weakness and our dependence upon God and come to Him with contrition and soul and brokenness of heart. Our petitions must be offered in perfect submission. Every desire must be brought into harmony with the will of God, and His will must be done in us. If we walk in the light as Christ is in the light, we may come to the throne of grace with holy boldness. We may present with the promises of God and live with faith and urge our petitions. Although we are weak and erring and unworthy, the Spirit also helps us in eternity. When we have offered our petition once, we must not yet abandon it, but say as did Jacob when he wrestled with all that of the angels, I will not let thee go except thou bless me, and like him we shall prevail. In closing, it is only by watching on our prayer and exercising biblical faith that Christians can persevere, can preserve integrity in the midst of temptation that Satan brings to bear upon them. Talk to your heart constantly, the language of faith. Jesus said that He will receive me, and I believe His word. I will praise Him, I will glorify Him. Satan will be pushed by my sight to suggest that you do not feel any more. Answer Him, have everything to be glad of, for I am a child of Christ.
Sail the sea of faith, find out before too long. How quickly blue skies can grow dark and gentle winds grow strong. And suddenly fear is like a white water pounding on your soul. But still we sail on, knowing that our Lord in control. Sometimes He calms the storm with a whisper, peace be still. He can settle any sea, but it doesn't mean He will. Sometimes He holds us close, lets the wind and waves go wild. Sometimes He calms the storm, and other times He calls His child. He has a reason for each trial that we pass through in life. And though we're shaken, cannot be pulled apart from Christ. now the driving rain beats down on those who hold to faith. A heart of trust will always be a quiet, peaceful place. Cause sometimes he calms the storm with a whisper, peace be still. He can settle any sea, but it doesn't mean he will. Sometimes he holds us close as the wind and waves go wild. Sometimes he calms the storm, and other times he calms his child.
In other words, saying you need to stand in the gap, you need to intercede on the behalf of others. And therefore, to get the full impact of what that entails, I want you to listen to something a little bit. get the point. It's not about fully understanding everything that is entailed in the petition, but God said to make sure that you pray for the peace of the world.
The best of me is is ready to begin. Then there are days when I feel I'm letting go and soaring on the wind. 'Cause I've learned in laughter or in pain how to survive.
It is very important that in 2021 you make prayer a priority.
As you can see already, and it's just been a week, how important it is to us today. How important it is to us to make sure that our prayer lives are active, that we're not stagnant or dormant. I praise God that as we continue to look to the Word of God, that we can indeed realize the truthfulness of this thought. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and seek my face, then I will hear from heaven, I will forgive their sins and heal their land. Our world is in a mess. I'm sure that you can see it. I don't have to tell you. You can see it clearly. My hope, my prayer, my desire is that you will indeed learn to look to the Lord and trust him and know for sure that what he says, he's well able to do. At this time, I invite you to join me as we pray. Heavenly Father, we do ask you to heal our land, that we ask you to give us things for the day, Lord God. Cleanse us from every moral defilement. Help us to be more like you, God. Help us to do that which is right and pleasing in this life. And Father, as we go throughout the remainder of our days here in this life, Lord God, may we make prayer a priority in our life. May we realize how important prayer is. Thank you for hearing me. Hearing our cry and our cry this morning, Lord God. I continue to pray for your people. Pray for our churches, pray for our country. I pray, dear Lord, that we will continue to work in this 11th hour to go into the gospel field and to seed that will be harvested to your glory and to the coming kingdom. Bless each and every person who will listen, dear Lord. Bless them, prosper them, and keep them, preserve them throughout this coming year, and grant them your peace and joy in Jesus Christ's name. That the words of my mouth and my faith in my heart shall testify that they will be answered.
You've been listening to Soul Cafe Radio. Join us next time for powerful messages, music, and more. And remember to visit our website at www.soulcafeonline.com.
Trust in him. Oh, he will not turn. take the pains of earth to the doors of heaven. When God's people pray, there is hope reborn, there is sin forgiven, and miracles you can't explain.
Humbled in spirit, broken before your throne, nothing of my will, Lord, just yours, yours alone. Jesus shines all God's majesty, and that is all I want the world to see. Like him.
like Jesus. Nothing but love, Lord. There is nothing more to seek. Serving as you did, so willingly and so meek. The power of your presence, oh,
listening to Soul Cafe Radio, food for the mind and soul.
lost in a world of confusion, walking through life all alone, holding the hand of illusion. I was a diamond covered in stone. Days spent looking, longing for that one thing that could make me.
You say